I'm a little nervous. What are you all guys gonna think about me? What do you think about me? Are you all curious about me? Or this is something new? Okay, it's not exactly new. I have spoken before, but still, whenever I come to speak, it's still new for me. And I think that all these emotions which I'm going through, or all of us go through, and it's very normal. Like, the beginning is always the most difficult part, I think. I'm a chess player, and like, we come from a country where we are so obsessed about becoming doctors and engineers, but okay, believe me, we need a lot of good doctors and engineers, because what would we do without them? Like, our life depends on them. Our life doesn't depend on me, on a chess player, but our life definitely depends on the doctor or the engineers we have. I'd like to say that, but this is kind of a stereotype thinking which we have, and yes, we have to become doctors and engineers, but do we really have to become doctors and engineers, all of us? How did I end up becoming a chess player? So I come from a very normal background. Like, I think when I was young, I also wanted to be a scientist. First an engineer and do some experiments. I wanted to become like my father, who is a scientist and who is a professor in chemistry. So I just wanted to become like him. I wanted to do my go study in the IIT. But then and I started, my father taught me chess and he thought it will help me in my studies. So that's how our thinking is going on. Still I want to become an engineer. And I won my first national title when I was 11 years old, and probably that changed, because then one of the biggest decisions to pursue something else other than what we normally do, like coming from this normal background and from this normal thinking, and for a normal girl, basically, it was also good in studies, so why take a risk? Like, do we all take risks? How many of us would take a risk to be something different? What if it doesn't work out? Maybe if I go on this regular pattern which we are following, I'll earn something well, and if I play chess, like, how do I end up? Will I become successful? Like, there's so many questions. Like, but more importantly, it's, I think, what that we should take more risks. Like, are we taking enough risks? So this is little me when I was a kid, and this is the first time ever I got a prize. And as a kid, when my sister used to get a lot of prizes in drawing and painting and things. So I used to cry all the time, I don't have any prize. So once during the annual sports event, I participated in a skipping race, and I worked very hard for it. Like, my mother said me that if your legs are paining by this practice, you'll definitely get a prize. And I got a silver, that this was my absolutely first prize I ever got. And I've come so far to, like, I played for India, and I've won, like, winning a medal at the Chess Olympiad at Norway. This was one of my best moments, because Chess Olympiads are like, all the countries participate and all the top players are there, and you win a medal there. It's a great feeling, like playing for your country, representing your country at the world level. This is also good. When you're doing well, it's all good, all very good. And, like, retaining my national title last year, I won my first senior national title in 2014, in which qualified me to participate in the World Championship, which will be held this year in October. So I'm very happy, like, how things are going on. I get invited to a lot of places like this and there, some felicitation programs. But all the time I meet people who ask me, like, ये खेल कूद तो बहुत अच्छा है पर पढ़ाई कहाँ तक चल रही है कैसी चल रही है पढ़ाई like but why have you invited me? Like, why do you know me? Is it because how much I have studied, and I also completed my graduation? But sometimes ask me, why did I complete it? And the only answer I can come up is because of the society. Like, we should learn. We should get a degree because we want to be learned, not because we want a degree, not because of the society wants us to be doctors and engineers. Like all of us here, all the engineer, aspiring engineers and doctors, like we really want you, but become one because you want to do it. And because you want to build something, you want to help some patient, you want to help people, and not because society wants you to become one. I have always been very focused as a kid, which I showed my earlier picture. Like, all the while I have been very what I have done. And I think it has worked for me because, like, I think when I'm working, I don't compare myself to others. I think that what is my goals? You achieve it, then you move on, you have another goal. And it just keeps on going. I have met many players. I met Vishy Anand, our only world champion, whom we have. And during my last tournament, he was playing in the same tournament as me. And I have seen him close, and I know people who know him from a very closer personal level than me. And at a time when sports is getting younger and younger, all the sports persons are becoming younger, and at this age, the amount of work he puts into his to remain at the top, it's just unbelievable. You cannot imagine. He works probably 14 hours a day, and he goes for physical exercise because that's also very important, not just for sports persons, but I think for all of us. To be in great shape, to be physically in great shape, and it will help us to be focused on our work and everything. It works quite a lot. And whenever I see this place, I ask myself, am I working hard enough? Like, I also want to become a top player. I meet Vishy Anand, our only world champion, I have my low points when it's just not going as I want it to go. And during those times, I think to myself, like, or sometimes maybe I'm depressed about something. So, what if it keeps me inspired and motivated? I think to myself, okay, some random thought like, okay, what if this is my last day on earth? Do I want to just sit idle and be gloomy? No, of course not. I want to make the most of that day. So I get back to my feet and keep working hard. Like, life is much more about you. There are so many people working for so many causes. So you always have to find inspiration to do something good and be positive all the time. I think that we all in some part of our life have to be a sports person, because sports has taught me, sports has made me who I am today. It has made me confident, made me disciplined, made me stronger, more independent. I travel alone to so many places. And I meet so many new people. There are so many challenges which I have to, which I come across, and it's not easy. Like it might come, like all of us think, oh wow, she's traveling so many places, but it's very rare that I get to see it. But this, it's very rare that you get to actually see some places. So, but still, I think because of all the tagging and what has, most importantly, what has sports taught me is all the defeats which happen, all the success and failures which are the part and parcel of our everyday life, like which happen to me regularly. Today I win, tomorrow I lose, like, happy, sad, all these emotions, it just happens every day, regularly. And I have to overcome it, I have to accept it, I have to move on. And because life doesn't stop with one win or one loss. We always have to move on. Okay, you win today and someone won tomorrow. But most important is that you keep working whatever you do, whatever you want to do. And sometimes it is that I think to myself that okay, I'm very happy when someone else does well, but what I think is all of us think that okay, she's doing well, he's doing well, so what should I do? Like, okay, this, if it's a positive thing, it's very good, but what I think is, I really don't care about what you do or what you think. I never spend a time about thinking about others. Like, it really doesn't matter to me what you are doing. It only matters because it doesn't matter whether you win or lose. It matters whether I win or lose. So it should be our motto. Like, in a positive way, we should always be striving to excel ourselves, to better ourselves. But of course, we should not be all narcissists and okay, it's only about me or okay, I am this, I am that. We have to be supportive of others, people who are doing good. We have to encourage them. We have to live together. But at the same time, do not spend so much time thinking about others. We have come to this world and we have a responsibility to do something. So we just have to do our work and be better ourselves. My motto in life is like, think big, sky is the limit. Thank you.